Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about code injections, examples, and how to prevent them. Let's get started. The Online Web Application Security Project helps organizations improve security posture by offering guidelines based on real-world scenarios and community-led open-source projects. Out of the various threats, OWASP considers code injection to be a commonly known threat mechanism in which attackers exploit input validation flaws to introduce malicious code into an application. We'll explore how a code injection attack is performed, the types of attacks, and how software teams can protect their web applications from injection flaws. What is code injection? Threat actors use code injection vulnerabilities to embed malicious code into a source code, which the application interprets and executes. During the malicious injection, attackers leverage that these systems construct part of a code segment using external data, while lacking sufficient input validation. The malicious code is typically built to control data flow, leading to loss of confidentiality and reduced application availability. Attackers identify user input validation flaws such as data format, allowed characters, and the amount of expected data, and use them as the basis for developing malicious code. OWASP ranks injection vulnerabilities as number one, with their detectability ranging from easy to complex. Though this sounds alarming, injection vulnerabilities are moderately hard to exploit with the proper practices and timely detection. Command injection versus code injection technique. While they are often confused, a code injection differs from a command injection vulnerability. Code injection is a collection of techniques that allow a malicious user to add his arbitrary code to be executed by the application. Code injection is limited to target systems and applications, since the code's effectiveness is confined to a particular programming language. On the other hand, command injection involves taking advantage of application vulnerabilities to extend the application's functionality so it can execute arbitrary commands. With command injection, attackers supply unsafe input to the system shell to execute OWASP commands on the vulnerable application. Code injection, also known as remote code execution or code evaluation, involves modifying an executable or script containing malicious code. Hackers first probe the application for attack surfaces that can accept untrusted data and use it when executing program code. These include direct inputs such as file uploads, form fields, or other data sources such as cookies and query string parameters. The introduction of code typically consists of a direct concatenation of character string, the PHP eval function, or its equivalent in another language. A successful exploit grants attackers access to the application's server-side interpreter. The attackers can use system calls to run commands on the server and penetrate further for deeper exploitation. Code injection, type of attack exploits. Types of code injection attacks differ depending on the programming language used to develop the application's source code and the attacker's malicious code. This section explores some common categories of code injection vulnerabilities attacks. Client-side code injection. In client-side injection, hackers exploit flaws in applications where input validation is performed at the browser before the data is sent to the server. Such attacks include SQL code injection. SQL is widely used in modern applications to build data structures and query datasets. Attackers target vulnerable configuration details in relational database management systems to control a web application's database server with malicious SQL statements. These statements modify SQL queries, granting hackers access to crucial data, such as login credentials and the application's configuration information. Python code injection. Applications built with Python, scripts that accept expressions from users and evaluate their input, can be used to inject malicious code. For example, consider a simple calculator script that accepts and evaluates expressions at the user's input shown here. A regular mathematical expression like 5 times 6 returns an expected result, 30. Suppose the target process has access privileges on malicious inputs such as import, OWASP, system, RM, RF, in the input form. In that case, all files and directories located in the scripts folder are deleted. Hang code injection, cross-site scripting. Attackers commonly use HTML code injection vulnerabilities to compromise how users interact with a web application. While doing so, the hacker injects malicious hangl into a trusted website, executing untrusted scripts on the end-user browser. Since the browser cannot detect the malicious script, the attacker can access session tokens, cookies, and other crucial data that the browser retains. Server-side code injection. Server-side code injection involves exploiting flaws in applications that validate user input at the server end. These include PHP code injection. Some web applications built in PHP may include an unsafe function that allows attackers to control part or all of the software. These flaws enable hackers to change the course of code execution by modifying parts of an input string. The code shown in the video processes user input using the PHP eval function. If the web application lacks sufficient input validation, hackers can gain information about the PHP version using the URL example shown here. The attackers can then enumerate all services running on the server by requesting the third example shown in the video. Server-side JavaScript injection. It is relatively easy to insert and use a website's own JavaScript code by finding a cross-site scripting vulnerability or by including code in the address bar. While it is often used in the developer's console as a debugging mechanism, attackers can utilize JavaScript injection vulnerabilities to orchestrate attacks, hijack registration forms, gain access credentials, and compromise system availability. While code injection attacks are common, and every organization is known to be affected by such vulnerabilities, here are some famous code injection attacks that occurred in the recent past. The GhostShell attack. GhostShell, a cybersecurity activist group, exposed over 30 million account details by taking advantage of SQL injection and poorly configured PHP scripts. The hacks, which targeted government and educational institutions, involved downloading numerous databases from different servers with broken authentication mechanisms. Using port scanning tools, the hackers could locate servers hosting crucial databases, then upload breach data to raise awareness of cybersecurity misconfiguration. Turkish government debt agency breach. Red Hack, a Turkish hacker group, claimed to have penetrated the Istanbul Special Provincial Administration's website, ios.gov.trotter, clearing people's debts to utility agencies. They utilized a simple SQL injection script to bypass the website's login page, granting administrator and end-user accounts access. Injection attacks on Harvard architecture devices. Cybersecurity researchers at Cornell University proved that buffer overflow techniques could be used to inject code into embedded devices that rely on Harvard architecture CPU design. These devices have limited memory, so they can only process small packets. Using various program vulnerabilities, the researchers proved that it is possible to inject permanent code into sensors so they can gain complete control of the host process. As long as attackers can exploit server-side interpreter settings by sending malicious data, almost any data input interface can be a vector for code injection attacks. These attacks are common since attackers can access fuzzers and scanners that find code injection flaws. The business impact of such attacks can range from mild to severe, depending on the data exposed and business functions implemented by the software. As a result, it is of utmost importance to fix incorrect server configurations, avoid untrusted data sources, and eliminate other injection vectors. Best practices to prevent code injection attacks. While use cases differ for different organizations, some best practices to eliminate code injection flaws in modern web applications. Utilize whitelisting for input validation. Whitelisting is simpler to set up and gives security teams stricter control over what data or types of input the application can process, thereby helping to reduce the risk of an attacker executing malicious code. Encode HTML outputs. Security teams should leverage contextual output encoding to convert malicious input into safer representatives, where user data can be displayed, but not executed as code. Use a static type system to enforce language separation. With static type systems, teams can develop declarative control checks without the additional runtime overhead. Leverage parameterized queries and criteria-based APIs to interpret user data strings. This ensures that APIs do not accept any string values other than those specified. Additionally, parameterized queries consider inputs of malicious commands as a string instead of an SQL command. Avoid using unsafe functions in source code. Avoiding all vulnerable code evaluation constructs when developing source code is essential. Developers should instead use secure, dedicated language-specific features to process user-supplied inputs. Use the happily flag for cookies to disable client-side script interaction. If the server sets the happily flag on every cookie it creates, it indicates that the cookie should not be accessible from the client side. Even with HTML injection flaws, the cookies cannot be revealed to third parties. Use SCA tools to find and fix issues. Teams should set up automatic static code checking tools to find and eliminate injection vectors in source code. Avoid JavaScript code serialization. Developers use code serialization to rearrange input data into a set of regular functions and expressions. Some versions of JavaScript serialization packages cannot correctly sanitize against untrusted characters in regular expressions. It is recommended as a best practice to avoid serialization unless absolutely necessary. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.